Hello and welcome back again to MBAbullshitDotCom. So the topic for this video is the efficient markets hypothesis, also known as EMH. And this is the basic video before we move on to a more advanced video on the efficient markets hypothesis. Remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. Alright, so let's get down to it. Now, before this video, it's best if you already know the meaning of fundamental analysis and technical analysis, also known as chart analysis, as tools for predicting share and stock price movements. Okay, share and stock is the same thing. Okay, some people say share price, some people say stock price. So make sure you know these two forms of stock price analysis before watching this video. Okay. Now, this basic video discusses the basics of efficient markets hypothesis, as well as the basic differences between strong market efficiency, semi-strong market efficiency, and weak market efficiency. Now, I know these words sound pretty intimidating right now, but don't worry, you will see how easy and simple it actually is when I show you the examples. Alright, now my next more advanced video will still actually be super easy, and you can find it at MBAbullshit.com, and it simply and easily explains how stock and share prices move up and down in efficient markets depending on people's expectations. Alright, so now let's get down to it for this basic video. Okay, first of all, it's best to recall basic stock investing. Okay, now basic stock investing or basic stock playing or trading or whatever you want to call it or whatever type, okay, they're not exactly the same. But anyway, in basic stock investing, it's a game of good news versus bad news. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, it depends on sales reports, for example. It could be sales reports, income reports, or profit reports if you want to call it. Anyway, what does this mean? It means that the good news or bad news regarding sales reports or profit reports are directly related to stock price. Okay, so basically, if the sales reports are good or the profit reports are good, then the price of shares are supposed to, or in theory, the price of shares or stocks go up. Okay, but if the sales reports show that, or if the sales reports of a company are bad, then the share price or the stock price of that same company should go down. Alright? So now, how might people earn money using the news? Okay, how might people earn money using the news? Well, let's just look at this story about Greedy Bob and Greedy Bill. Alright? Now, let's say that Bob here is the CEO of a company, and he sees the latest company sales reports, and he sees that the company is doing great. Okay, and let's just say that this company that Bob works for is listed in the stock market. Alright? So Bob, the CEO, sees the latest sales report, and he sees that his company is doing great. What he might do is, he does not announce this report to the public yet, and instead he tells his buddy Bill about this great sales report before telling the public. Now, what does Bill do? Okay, Bill buys the stock or buys the share of stock before the news announcement about this company's great sales report. Alright, just make that a bit more visible over here. Before this great sales report. And then, what happens? Bob then decides to announce it to the public, and after the news announcement, the share price goes up. And what happens to Bill? Bill gets rich quick. Why? Because he bought the stock before the news announcement, and then there was a news announcement, and then Bill's share price went up. So Bill gets rich quick. Alright, so that's one way people can earn money, by trading the news. Alright, so basically this is the story about Greedy Bob and Bill. What actually happened here? Okay, what actually happened here? Well, number one, Bob, the CEO, learns about the good news. At first, he tells only his buddy Bill about the good news. Bill buys the stock in advance, and then Bob announces the good news to the public, to people like your grandma, who are very often you have these grandma investors who don't know much about the inside information of the company, about the secret information of the company. And then it's only after people like grandma hear about the news that the stock price goes up. And then people like Bill over here get rich quick. And grandma here, okay, did not get rich quick because she heard about this good news already after Bill made money on it. So in other words, people like grandma hear about the news too late together with everyone else. Okay, so she's not so happy over there. And you might say, well, why doesn't she earn money? The stock price still went up. Well, in theory, remember that in stock trading, for you to win, someone else has to lose. Okay, because you buy the stock cheap, or Bill here buys the stock cheap, and then he sells it expensive. Okay, who does he sell it expensive to? Well, he sells it expensive to people like grandma after the price has already gone up. So in theory anyway, in stock trading, for you to win, someone else must lose. In this case, Bill won against grandma. So in theory, Bill bought the stock when it was still low priced, before the announcement, and then sold it to grandma at a high price after the announcement. Okay. However, this is actually what happens. Okay, this does not happen in what we call an efficient market. Okay, so, well, anyway, or another way of saying it is, we saw this bad situation over here. Okay, but actually, in a perfectly efficient market, that would not happen. This bad thing that happened over here, this bad situation between Bill, Bob, and Grandma, this would not happen in a perfectly efficient market. Why? Because in a perfectly efficient market, there's number one example, there's good news, and then number two, even if Bob is the CEO, Bob, Bill, and Grandma all learn about the good news at the same time, even if Bob is CEO. Okay, in an efficient market, or in a perfectly efficient market. Why is that? Because in a perfectly efficient market, alright, so the key word here is perfectly efficient, all relevant information about the company, okay, such as the sales report, okay, flows or moves or travels instantly or super quickly between Bob, Bill, and Grandma. So Bill does not have an advantage even if he's the buddy of Bob, which is the CEO. Alright. Now, in MBA bullshit language, alright, in business school bullshit language, okay, instead of saying perfectly efficient market, we usually say strong market efficiency. So if you're in business school, you're wondering what this strong market efficiency is that the textbook or your professor keeps on talking about. They're talking about a perfectly or almost perfectly efficient market, like this situation over here. Like this situation over here, where they all learn about the information at the same time or almost the same time. Okay, so what does this mean for investors? It means that in a perfectly efficient market with strong market efficiency, at any one time, anyone and everyone already knows all relevant information about a share of stock. So nobody can earn money by using any information such as this sales report over here. Okay. This sales report over here. Okay. Nobody can earn money using this information to analyze and predict the future share or stock price movements, either up or down. So people like Bill cannot use the information to beat Grandma. Why? Because Grandma already knows the same information too, at the same time that Bill knows it. So it's useless to use inside information. Inside, now, what is inside information? What's the difference between information? Well, what's the difference between information and inside information? Inside information just means the secret information that only Bill and Bob know. Okay, Grandma doesn't know it yet. It's a secret. Inside means like secret information or advanced information that Bob knows. But in a perfectly efficient market with strong market efficiency, it is useless to use inside information, fundamental analysis, or even technical analysis to give you or to give Bill an advantage in stock investing. Why? Because fundamental and technical analysis are based on information. And since these two are based on information, how can these two give you an advantage if the information you are using is already known by everyone? Remember, in stock market investing, okay, you have an advantage if you know about this information before other people know it, right? Therefore, Bill also does not have an advantage when he uses fundamental analysis, which uses that information, and he also does not have an advantage when he uses technical analysis, which also uses information, or which is also based on information.